Welcome back to our Proactive Newsroom. I'm Natalie Stoberman, joined by the CFO of Guardforce AI, Brian Ma. Brian, thank you for joining me.
Thank you for having me here. Thank you.
Anytime. Brian, we have a big update to discuss around an acquisition in China. Can you give us some details around that agreement?
Sure. Absolutely. In this acquisition, we are acquiring the robotic business related assets from Kewei, which are the most pivotal to us. By this asset acquisition, these assets are composed of four major parts. First one is the selected equipment that is used for leasing and advertising. Second is the precious client base, including current and pipeline. Third is related sales and channel stuffs. Fourth is we will be able to use Kewei's registration patterns in reality to our robot business permanently. Meanwhile, Kewei has been building up its sales channels since 2019 and has sales forces that access to all the major metropolitan cities in China, providing services across diverse industries in terms of restaurants, hotels, and office buildings. Nevertheless, Fortune 500 customers. This is a milestone for us to swiftly penetrate market and gain revenue streams into real. To sum up, the transaction is valued at $2.1 million, and it will be paid in full with restricted ordinary shares of Guardforce AI. We believe after completing this acquisition totally with shares, illuminating determination from Kewei shareholders' dedication and contribute to our confidence toward REST business flourish. Thanks.
Thank you, Brian. Now, when it comes to this acquisition, how does this provide an opportunity for more growth for Guardforce AI, especially in the robotics as a service niche?
First to mention is we have successfully already acquired two robotic companies in China in this month, whereas give us a burgeon in the market of China with the asset acquired by the new acquisition together with former robotic companies. We've acquired our forward-looking total robotic related revenue across China will be aggregated about 12 million in the coming next year. And the compound growth projected sustainable up to the next 3 years. Our revenue streams from robotic rental, advertising, and technical service will fully cover to the most metropolitan city in China. Our revenue streams after these mergers and permanent usage of the robotic related patterns with software we've acquired from Kewei will hinge a solid foundation to the REST capabilities. We foresee the loosening of pandemic zero clearance policy in China, demanding more labor-security gap healing in the tip of time. And automation is essentially clocking. In general, China is the most favorable of newbie adoption for new economic like our RAS information services to be as they are fundamental of daily life.
So it sounds like there's a lot of opportunity for growth, but when it comes to the acquisition, only assets were purchased, not the entire company. Why was that?
It's because considering the merge in an efficient way by acquiring its asset has its own merit in time and cost saving. Meanwhile, by way of value chain analysis of this acquiree, we knew the sales function is most critical to success in our business strategy for developing the REST business. Therefore, we picked the most valuable part of Kewei to start execution of this M&A. Under this backdrop, we've gained existing market penetration, client base, sales channel, and forces. Furthermore, nothing is compared with the seamless revenue stream popping up in our P&L immediately.
And how did that business strategy lead to valuing the shares at 20 cents a share?
Okay, Yes, we've been working successfully in negotiation with the acquirees shareholders by way of 103% shares delivery instead of 90% share plus 10% cash. It means 100% of our share equity as a base for this acquisition. It has a huge meaning to us from both sides, determination in strategic alliance and positive forward-looking minded. The 0.2 price is adjusted to the current market price. But once it unveils corporate's intrinsic value, it will benefit to all the shareholders while booming.
Thank you very much for breaking down this update for us, Brian.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you, Natalie.
Again, the CFO of Guardforce AI, Brian Ma.